Whoa. today. Father, we thank you for your presence. We thank you for the healing power that is so mighty in this house today. And I would thank you with the spirit of might, which is the miracle working ability that is so mighty in this house today. And through this power, your people will be delivered, your people will be healed.
Of the invisible God. So in other words, now we get to understand that we get to understand that in this scripture there is divinity.
Okay.
Because now it is the image, which means the image is physical. Invisibility is spiritual. So now we get to understand that supernatural is materializing the natural.
Okay.
And whatever the natural, supernatural materializes into the natural, there is a sign of divinity. The Bible says now, all things were created by him and for him. That's what John says. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and that Word was God. He was with God in the beginning, and all things were created by him, and without nothing was made that was made. And now Adam says, I heard his voice walking. He's a voice, but heard him walking. So in other words, he heard supernatural walking. So even in the book of Genesis, the supernatural materializes to the natural. So now we get to understand there is divinity here. And whenever there is divinity, it means there is God. And whenever there is manifestation of God, there is power. There is glory. Whenever there is glory, there is power. There is God. What is glory? When we speak of glory, we speak of totality, not manifestation of the capacity of God. Something that cannot be done by man. Something that supersedes the creation of mankind. That's when we speak of glory.
Because this is not what I prepared. Shula barazanza baza, reisha barando kososo, randusha magabalaza, la ronda reisha kabalatela. When we read the book from verse 17, it says, and he is before all things, and by him all things consist. Verse 18, it says, and he is the dead, he is the head of the body. He is the firstborn of every creature, not of every man, but of every creature. And now God says, if a man be in Christ, behold, he is a new creature. So now we get to understand now that Jesus is the firstborn of the creatures. And now that we are in Christ, we cease to be man, but we become creatures. I don't know if I'm talking here. Verse 19 says, for it pleased God, the Father, that in him all fullness should dwell. It pleased God that the fullness of God should dwell in Jesus. What is the fullness of God? I told you that when we speak of the fullness, we speak of. So in other words, in him has the ability to do that which only God can do. So in other words, in him, he carried the glory of God. He carried that which only God can do. What is the glory of God? When we speak of the glory of God, we speak of the I amness of God. What is the I amness of God? We speak of God's relevant power. God's ability to be relevant in any situation, in any generation, in any dispensation, and in any era. That is the glory of God. So now, he says, he's the firstborn of every creature. So in other words, each and every creature possesses the same ability that he carries. Why? Because now if he is the firstborn, it means those who come after him carry the same DNA as him. The title of our message is The Relevant God. When we speak of relevancy, we speak of the capacity to meet current needs. So in other words, God is able to stand up and meet current needs. He is the relevant God. He cannot manifest as a healer when he needs provision. In him is relevancy. Who says,
one day, the Syrian king wanted to attack the Israelites. Moses now, he attacked them from the plain, and the Israelites conquered. And he attacked them from the valley. Even in the valley, they conquered. So when the Israelites conquered in the plain, they said, okay, it means that God is the God of the plain. Now God is only relevant in the plain. They missed something, that God is relevant in any season. So they went back to attack them from the valley. And let me tell you, even I walk through the valley of the shadow, I know He is with me. So even in the valley, He is there. The reason why there is a shadow is symbolizes there is a greater light. Whenever there is a shadow, if this is light and there is a shadow, it's a sign that there is a greater light. So even in the valley, He is still relevant. Everything that you're encountering, He is right there with you. And if God is on our side, power is on our side. And if God is on our side, victory is on our side. He is the relevant God. You know, they said, they also conquered in the valley. So it means that God is also the God of the valleys. They said, let's come. Let's go and attack from the valley, from the mountain. There was no other thing that's happened. God is still there. God is relevant in everything that you're encountering. He's right there where you are. The Bible says, one time He took Paul and Silas up to the prison. Even there in the inner cell, by the hand of God, they managed to pull out. So in other words, when you carry glory, you carry the capacity to be relevant. It doesn't matter what you're going through. If you carry God, you will be relevant. Moses, if a man been crushed, he's a new creature. So in other words, when you're now a creature, you are a new man. In another translation, it says, if any man be in Christ, God is in a new world. Praise the Lord. So now when you're in a new world, there are certain functionalities that you're acquired. There are certain elements that you have acquired. Am I talking here? Praise the Lord. So now when you've acquired this ability, you cease from being a man, but now you become a creature. Am I talking here? Praise the Lord. It says now you become a creature. I want us to open from the book of John, chapter number 2. Let's get someone to read verse 11 and 12.
To convert energy to bring heat, they're able to convert energy to do
so many things. So same with the glory of God. The glory of God can be converted. Praise the Lord. We did something in science in high school. I forgot what they call it. But it says, energy cannot be created, but it can be converted. So same with the glory of God. Why? Because the glory of God is the covenant of God. God cannot be created. Neither is his glory cannot be converted. It can be created. But it can be converted to meet our needs. We cannot create the glory of God. Why? Because the glory of God is the manifestation of his presence. Inasmuch as we cannot create his presence, we cannot create his glory. But we can convert his presence to meet our needs. So right in the wedding, they ran out of wine. Jesus is able to heal the sick, but they were able to convert his presence in order to bring out the new wine. I don't know what is it that you're encountering in your life, but as long as you carry glory, you carry hope. Because there is a mission that has been hidden from any generation, that Christ in us is the hope of glory. We carry glory in us, we carry hope. Anything that we encounter, we are relevant, because there is power, there is the ability of God to be relevant. The glory of God will be made manifest. I'm closing now. I'm still building up. So now, we are like him. I want you to understand that if we are like him, it means we carry the same unction as him. Who says in the book of 1 John, number 2, verse 10, for you have received the unction of the Holy One. So now Jesus said that to his disciples before he departed, that when you must wait, tarry here in Jerusalem, and the Holy Ghost will come upon you. In other words, the action will come upon you, and when it comes upon you, you will receive power, you will receive new ability, you will receive new capabilities. You will be able to execute certain elements that you are not able to execute before. The Bible says, even though we live in this world, but we are not of this world. That's why when the world says there is a casting down, we shall say there is a lifting up. Because there is something in us, there are certain elements that the Lord has deposited in us. There is power in us. We carry the ability to be relevant in any season. God says, our present summaries, they are not worth compared with the glory that will be revealed in us. So in other words, there is a greater glory that will be revealed in us. The Bible says now, the world is waiting in greater dispensation, awaiting for the manifestations of the sons of God. The world wants to see power. The world wants to see glory in us. As the sons of God, the Bible says we have access to the solutions to every problem that the world is facing. It is high time we stop that nonsense of us going to school so they will get money and take care of our kids, and the same process continues like that. It is an error. That is survival. We are not born for the purpose of survival. Those who are surviving are those who are receiving manna, because they came to eat manna and they continued with the journey. They did nothing. They received everything for free. But we don't receive everything for free. We carry power in us. We must be relevant in this generation. I know some of you are saying, but how can we do these things? Why, my works are not qualified. Paul says, I am everything that I am by the grace of God. And the Bible says in the book of John, chapter number 1, verse number 16, for through him we have received grace for grace. Grace for grace in business, grace for grace in ministry, grace for grace in everything that we do, grace for grace in forex, grace for grace in our families, grace for grace in our relationship, grace for grace in our marriages. It is a narrow way, child of God, to be in a relationship that is failing every time. It is power. It is time for us to stand out in the capacity of grace, executing that which God can do, that Him, only Him can do, because the glory of God is within us. For Christ in us is the hope of glory, and through Him we can do anything. There is nothing impossible with God. There is nothing impossible with me. I carry capacity. And in this generation, I will manifest, not by might, not by power, but by the Spirit of God. But since the days of John the Baptist, up until now, the kingdom of God.
number 8, verse 8.
We carry God in us. We carry the ability to be relevant in this dispensation.
We carry divine functionalities. But we say, so take us of the divine nature. We are members of his household. We carry God in us. We cannot fail. If he cannot fail, I cannot fail. If he cannot die, I cannot die. If he cannot be sick, I cannot be sick. I carry God in me, the creator of the universe. He possesses my being. Christ in me is the hope of glory. So even in this dispensation, we shall be relevant. Put us in any situation. Take us to the wilderness. We'll turn into the fruitful crowd. Take us into the village. We'll turn it into the city. Take, give me anything. Give me medicine. I will give you distinction. Give me natural sciences. I'll give you distinction. Give me LLP. I'll give you distinction. We are relevant in anything that we do. As Joseph, they took him to a foreign land. He became a prime minister. Take me to Zimbabwe, I become a president. Ask Obama to give from China to America, he become a president. Take me anywhere, I carry God in me. Bible says the end is of the Lord, and the fullness thereof. If he is the one who created the world, and I have the action upon him. Isaiah says, I have received the spirit of lordship. I have received the spirit of the Lord, which is the spirit of lordship. In other words, in this land, I will become a Lord. I am a Lord in this land. I am a borrower. I am a giver. I refuse to borrow. Paul says, I was a child, and now I am older, and I have never seen the righteous. Be forsaken of the Lord, not their children. For bread, you carry God in you. You will not make bread. You will not for bread. But Christ the Lord, come and show this. But Christ the Lord, we carry God in us. We break barriers. We break limitations. In Canada, we get home. The Lord said unto Joshua, and the land you put your foot in, you possess again. The Bible says, he sent the spies unto the land of Canaan. And when they came back, they said, with our giants, I don't know whether the giants or not, I carry God in me. When the Lord has promised that Canaan is mine, I am entering there, not by might, but by power, not by the spirit, of God. Let me tell you something. Says he's not a man that he can lie. Neither is he a son of man that he can change his mind. If he says it's yours, it is yours. Sometimes people go through delays and will think God is late. Any delay that is not of God, it is broken today. You will possess that which is promised. You're going through that the Lord is not the one taking you through it. In the end today, you shall receive that which God wants you to have. Even though a vision may tarry, but in the fullness of time, it will be established. It doesn't matter. And all now see the circumstances around you, they might be telling that you're not going to become that which God said you're going to become. But in the fullness of time, I will become that which God said I will become. If God said you will be an apostle, it doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter if they're not giving you a pulpit. God is not a man that you can lie. Neither is he a son of man that he can change his mind. Praise the Lord. Let me tell you something. I usually don't tell people this testimony, but I think it's relevant for now. In 2015, we went to Malabar Stadium with my father. It was raining such an extent that there were chairs there on the field, but because of rain, the man of God had to say to stay alone there at the stage, and people ran to the crest there. But there's something that I did to provoke the action upon him. As he was preaching in the rain, I carried an umbrella. I went to him. He was preaching, and rain was falling on me. No more to one of the crest there. So there's a time where you get to provoke the anointing. Let me tell you something. When I started preaching, most people were saying to me, yes, you are a preacher, but that's what's going to happen with you. God is not going to establish you to any stage or to any office. But because I provoked the anointing upon the man of God, and he said, my usher you. Because back then, before this, I received many promises. People were saying, yeah, you are a man of God. You are going to preach, you are going to be a powerful teacher, but you're not going to have your own church. You're not going to be in any office. But the day I provoked the action upon him, ever since from that day, any man of God prophesies upon me, he says, you're an apostle. Yes. So there is a level where you get to provoke the action that is the action of God. You press demand on the anointing. You press demand on the anointing. Bible said there is a voice that is said in Rema. It is Rachel crying for your children, and she refused to be comforted. Most of the time, what makes people to get what God has promised them is because we allow people to comfort us. But because I was not comfortable, I said, God, I cannot fast. I cannot go to mountain prayers and I just become an ordinary teacher. I press the man on the anointing, and the action that is upon him released virtue. Bible says now, Jesus, one day, as he was passing by, there was a woman with the issue of blood, and she said unto herself, if I can only touch the hem of his garment. Bible says now, she touched. And when she touched, Jesus stood and said, something left me. Bible says, virtue left me. In other words, when you possess glory, there is virtue inside of you. In this generation, we are raising young men and women of virtue. We shall be relevant. Everything that we encounter, we carry virtue in us. We refuse to be small. We need young leaders who will have virtue. Those who refuse to be nobodies. We need young men and women of virtue. Those who will be relevant in this dispensation. Those who refuse to beg. It is an error for us to carry God in us and you stay at home. No one was created to sit down. The Bible says, we'll carry God in us. Let me tell you something. That's what God created Adam. Fruitful and multiply. So in other words, we get to understand that whenever man sits down, he gets bored. Why? Because he was created in the nature to do something. That's how Paul says, everything that I am, it is by the grace of God. He says, I am labored. Let me correct something. Grace does not replace hard work. If you say grace replaces hard work, there's grace for you to be a doctor. But you're not a doctor now. There are certain things that you must invest in order for you to get there. Grace was there for Peter to get money to pay tax. But he had to labor. That's about David. Jesus said unto him, go and fish, and from the fish that you will catch, you will remove money from the mouth. So now, grace. You see now, Peter was a fisherman. So in other words, if there was no grace and he was told you must catch a fish and you get money from the mouth, he wouldn't have known that the first fish I will catch is the one that has money. So grace is there to make sure that which God has given to you, there is no delay. That work must be there, but there will never be delay because grace is there. If there was no grace, the same thing which happened to him when he first met Jesus. When he said, I've been toiling all night, there was no grace for him that time. So the same would have happened when he needed money to pay tax. He would have toiled the whole night and did not know that the first fish which I had is the one which has my solution. But because of the availability of grace, that which he was needed, you got to access it quickly. Am I talking here? So you need grace in order for you to get that which God has given you. So when we say we have received grace for grace, it means we have received grace for business. It means when we enter business, we will not struggle. But it does not mean we will enter business and sit down. That's what many people say, giving does not work. Do you know? know why? It's because they give, and after giving, they go and sleep. And they think when they wake up in the morning, they will find dollars under their pillow. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We want to go and pray now. Praise the Lord. We carry glory in us. I want us to open the book of Philippians, chapter number 4, verse 13.
God in me. I carry the nature of God in me.
is in every part of me. Let me tell you something. God is inside of you. Everything that you need is inside of you. We carry the life of God in us. In every fiber of our being. In every cell of our bodies. In our blood. It's flowing in our veins. We carry the nature of God in us. We cannot be poor in this world. We cannot make in this world. We refuse to be small. We are not the last, but we are the best. We are not the tenth, but we are the eighth. We are the peculiar people. We are the chosen generation. We are a city that is set on the hills. We cannot be hidden. Christ in us is the hope of glory, and will be cut forth to show the excellence of God. Lift up your hands. Say, my father, my fighter. Give me the grace to be relevant in this generation. Give me the grace to be relevant in this generation. Begin to pray where you are.
My father, give me the grace to be relevant.
In Jesus' name we pray. Lift up your heads. Close your eyes. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, that whom you are raising in this generation to be relevant, in the mighty name of Jesus, touch them now. Holy Spirit, begin to move now and touch them. Begin to move and touch them. Man, woman of virtue. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I say, in this spirit that is delaying you to be relevant in this generation, let it be destroyed now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, begin to move in this place. Father of God, begin to move. In the mighty name of Jesus, men and women of faith, those who be relevant in this season, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Show you in a vision and you're prophesying to my mind. Because the way I show it is, you're knowledge of God, and he will establish you. And believe in his promise, you will prosper. There's grace for you to go through. You are a man of God. There is oil upon you.
What's wrong? Your ears. They again, you know you cannot hear.
voice that is speaking. I say, oh, brother, I'm speaking to you. I don't know, but I'm trying to locate this person. Brother. This person was a herbalist or something. That's why I'm asking you, in your family, was there someone who was always ever been a herbalist? Because I see that this spirit is like an ancestral spirit. I still speak.
Yeah.